Right now, live at 5, as the cold continues to hit us here at home, places around the country, including Texas, are dealing with winter weather that has turned destructive. Meanwhile, there's a new call for an independent commission to look into the riots at the U.S. Capitol. Plus, a Minnesota health expert is forecasting a dark 14 weeks ahead in the pandemic. And later,
we spoke with medical professionals and travel agencies about what you need to know ahead of planning for spring break.
You're watching Live at 5 on Live Local CBS 3.
Welcome to the CBS 3 News Live at 5. Here's a live look from San Antonio, Texas, where the winter weather has continued to cause big problems for the southern state over the last few days. That includes in Houston, where some special freezers lost power, triggering a frantic effort to vaccinate thousands against COVID-19 before the doses went bad. Good evening and thanks for joining us. I'm Kristen Bakke. We have been facing this bitter cold for the last week, but we are not alone. This nasty weather is affecting more than two-thirds of Americans. The weather system is dropping snow, ice, and some of the coldest temperatures in a decade. Elise Preston has the latest from New York.
For the first time ever, the entire state of Texas is under a winter storm warning as a wicked storm dumps snow and ice over the deep south. The massive system left Seattle with the most snow it's seen in almost 40 years and is making driving dangerous in areas where people are not used to snow and ice.
Our roads, no matter how much we salt them, are not designed for it.
This man jumped to safety seconds before a vehicle slammed into a patrol car, already tending to another crash in Schulenburg, Texas. Conditions are also lousy in parts of Arkansas, Missouri, and Kentucky.
Today and tomorrow, we're advising you to limit travel as much as possible.
And Chicago is expecting up to a foot of snow.
Just hunker down and do what we need to do and be safe. And then whatever happens, Mother Nature will do her thing.
Air travel is also difficult. By midday, airlines canceled or delayed nearly 5,000 flights across the U.S.
It's not just the snow and ice that's making it miserable for people across large sections of the country. It's also the bitter cold.
The thermometer dropped to minus 38 degrees in Hibbing, Minnesota this morning. It was 26 below in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, and minus 19 in La Crosse, Wisconsin. But in Houston, kids are taking delight in the rare weather. Forecasters say as this system moves out, another one is right behind it. The Midwest could see another half foot of snow Tuesday into Wednesday. Elise Preston, CBS News, New York.
It's so cold in Texas that officials have initiated rolling blackouts as they work to conserve energy. At least 2 million customers went without power for short periods of time today. And while people across the country are dealing with snow and ice, here at home, we're continuing to see those frigid cold temperatures. Here's a live look over the city of Duluth. In response to the cold temps, the city's warming center will stay open through Sunday. It's located at the Rainbow Center in downtown Duluth and will stay open from 6 p.m. to 10 a.m. The warming center will also be open for 24 hours on Saturday and Sunday. Well, Dave joins us now for a first look at the weather. A little shout out to Hibbing and those very cold temperatures there this morning.
And they'll hit us one more time.
All right.
Getting towards the 30 below range again by tomorrow morning. Of course, we have the umpteenth wind chill advisory in effect here tonight, which is with the entire area now till about 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. We'll show you that map here just to prove the point. Indeed, even the Upper Peninsula now, this time around, has joined the cold parade. But it should be the last time. We take a look at the bigger picture. There's that monster low leaving Texas and heading up towards places like Tennessee and Kentucky and its fringes gracing Chicago. But the Arctic high pressure is keeping us dry. So we may be cold, but we don't have to deal with that foot of snow. What are we dealing with on our short term? Well, one more night of cold, like I mentioned. 25 below here in the Twin Ports tomorrow morning. 30, 35 below farther inland. Sunshine hits us again on Tuesday. But then a southerly wind comes around and we go from 8 below to 8 above. Today we hit 0, which is an improvement. Tomorrow, 8 above. Warmer than that by midweek. By the weekend, we could be warmer than normal. And we'll talk about that temperature progression coming up in a few more minutes.
All right, thanks, Dave. A Minnesota expert is forecasting a dark 14 weeks ahead for the pandemic. Michael Osterholm is an epidemiologist and infectious disease expert at the University of Minnesota. He was also a member of President Joe Biden's Transition Advisory Board on COVID-19. In an interview on CBS This Morning today, he said the new COVID-19 variants could mean that the worst of the pandemic has yet to hit the U.S. Osterholm said the nation is in a race between the variants and the vaccine.
If I had to put my money right now on saving the most lives, keeping our hospitals open, operating as best they can, I would put all my vaccine in 65 years and older. And I know teachers may not want to hear that, but I think that's the right message.
The CDC issued new opening guidance for schools on Friday. Osterholm says he expects schools to be able to safely operate under that advice, but expects that the COVID variants may force schools to change plans over the next few months. And just a reminder, we've set up a local vaccine information center on our website to ensure you can stay up to date on the latest information as it becomes available. You can find it on CBS3Duluth.com. The U.S. Senate voted Saturday to acquit former President Trump of inciting the January 6th insurrection at the U.S. Capitol. But questions about the attack remain, leaving some lawmakers calling for more in-depth investigation. Skylar Henry has more details from Capitol Hill.
House Speaker Nancy Pelosi announced following the acquittal of former President Trump, Congress's next step will be to create an independent commission to investigate the January 6th domestic terrorist attack on the U.S. Capitol.
There's still more evidence that the American people need and deserve to hear, and a 9/11 commission is a way to make sure that we secure the Capitol going forward and that we lay bare the record of just how responsible and how abjectly violating of his constitutional oath President Trump really was.
The idea is gaining bipartisan support, with even some of the president's staunchest allies calling for the commission.
Did Nancy Pelosi know on January the 5th that there was a threat to the Capitol? What did President Trump do after the attack? And I want to make sure that the Capitol footprint can be better defended next time.
Concern about a possible next time remains high. CBS News has obtained a DHS intelligence report saying domestic extremists will pose an increased threat to government workers and buildings throughout 2021. The report says many groups may feel emboldened by the success of the January 6th assault. And Congressman Joe Neguse, who was part of the House impeachment prosecution team, says that may have intensified after Mr. Trump's acquittal.
Without accountability, that many of these groups could very well become more emboldened and perhaps engage in more violence.
Lawmakers have already tasked retired Lieutenant General Russell Honoré to conduct a security review of the U.S. Capitol. Skylar Henry, CBS News, Capitol Hill.
Speaker Pelosi also called on Congress to appropriate more money for Capitol security. Looking ahead, Wisconsin's governor is set to lay out his full budget plan tomorrow night. Governor Tony Evers will discuss his ideas Tuesday at 7 p.m. The budget covers the next 2 years. It includes things like pandemic recovery funding, child and long-term care support, rural initiatives, improvements for mental health care, and dropping prescription drug prices. The governor is also expected to announce a plan to legalize and tax marijuana as a way to increase revenue. The Republican-controlled legislature will also draft a budget and vote on that later this year. Milwaukee will welcome President Joe Biden tomorrow on his first official visit since taking office. The president will host a town hall. He's expected to discuss the pandemic and the economy. The event is set to start at 8 p.m. It is invite only. A big education position is up for a statewide vote in Wisconsin tomorrow. The primary for the state superintendent race is on the ballot. In Superior, residents can vote in person from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. You can also drop off your absentee ballot until 8 o'clock at the city clerk's office or in front of the government center. Early voting has ended, so has the chance to request an absentee ballot. We have more information on each of the candidates on our website, CBS3Duluth.com. The general election will be held in April. Still to come on Live at 5, new job opportunities are on their way for the Ashland, Wisconsin area, and a weekly event at the Great Lakes Aquarium is almost at its end for the season. More on that as we take you around the region after the break. And coming up tonight at 6, the American Birkebeiner begins next week in a way it has never been done before. All the changes and what you need to know tonight.
You're watching Live at 5 with Kristen Vaki. Anthony Matt, and weather with meteorologist Dave Anderson on Live Local CBS 3.
Local news and local weather here on CBS 3.
Being overweight may lead to high blood pressure, diabetes, heart disease, a weakened immune system, and can make COVID-19 even more risky. At Healthy Systems USA, get your free weight loss consultation from the comfort of your own home. Call or go to HealthySystemsUSA.com.
We remember your name. Hi, Cheryl.
Hello.
Because it's your name. That's simple human sense.
Ask the Holden Insurance Agency if auto owners make sense for you.
Last year, when people were going hungry, Subaru and our retailers donated 50 million meals to Feeding America. And yet, one in four children may still face hunger. So as part of our love promise, Subaru and our retailers are doing it again, donating an additional 100 million meals to help those in need. Love. It's never been needed more than right now. Subaru. More than a car company.
It is the question that matters the most. Without it, our purpose, Robert, and our freedom fade. This is why.
Coming up tonight, what medical professionals want you to know ahead of spring break travel.
Boy, it was cold again this morning, and we'll have another cold one tomorrow morning, but then we should start to warm up. We'll talk about the process
tonight at 6 on CBS 3.
I'm Clarice.
Are you famous?
Sort of.
You've got iron in your veins, darling.
I don't like this, Clarice.
I am trying to find out how deep this goes.
Buffalo Bill can't seem to let you go.
Just doing my job.
Would you like to lose a pound of fat a day?
You know, everyone just treats me a little bit differently, a little bit better. You know, I feel more comfortable in social situations.
Before, when I walked by a mirror, I would duck. I wouldn't look. Now it's like, where's that girl?
Order online or call today for a free consultation.
Welcome back to the CBS 3 News Live at 5. Here's a live look from Grand Rapids, Minnesota. As we kick off the week, Dave will be in with this week's forecast in just a few minutes. But first, let's take a look around the region. If you've been wanting to get back outside during the cold snap, the reopening of a local warming house might be a hopeful sign that these temps are on the way out. And if it's still too cold, the Great Lakes Aquarium has a fun indoor activity. All of that and more as we take you around the Northland, city by city. We'll start things off tonight in Duluth with a sign that these frigid temperatures might just be on their way out. The Bayfront Warming House reopened today for regular hours after being closed for several days due to the extreme cold. The Warming House offers a concession stand and free ice skate rentals. While the ice rink is open from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. daily, the Warming House only operates from 3 to 7 Monday to Friday and 12 to 4 Saturday and Sunday. Well, we'll stay in Duluth, but head inside for a warmer activity held at the Great Lakes Aquarium. Wednesdays this winter have been Wonder Wednesdays and at the aquarium. The events were held to help get into a rhythm despite all the changes due to COVID-19 and to create warm and happy memories at the aquarium. Tickets are only $6 when purchased on site, and this event only runs for 2 more weeks. And finally tonight, we wrap up with a new job opportunity coming to those in the Ashland, Wisconsin area. Xcel Energy has announced they're looking to expand their off-site home-based recruiting to the area. They're looking for more employees in their customer service and credit contact centers. Due to the pandemic, they've been able to make all of these positions work-from-home jobs. This is the first time the Wisconsin-based company is looking outside of Eau Claire to fill these jobs. Around 30 openings are available. If there's something going on in your neighborhood that you think we should know about, send us an email and it might be featured as we go around the Northland, city by city. Still to come on Live at 5, this winter weather is sure to create the urge for some spring break travel. What medical professionals say to keep in mind if you do plan on traveling after the break.
It was an awfully cold week, and we started pretty brisk this morning, 24 below, for example, at the airport in Duluth. But that afternoon high of 2 above is a sign that we're starting to ease our way out slowly. but surely from the big long cold snap. We'll talk about what we're going to hit tomorrow coming up after our break.
It is the question that matters the most. Without it, our purpose, Robert, and our freedom fade. This is why.
Amazing power, amazing speed. One ultra cool price. Take your internet to the extreme, starting at $19.99 a month for 1 year. Experience blazing hot speeds from 60 meg up to 1 gig. Turn up the intensity with powerful in-home Wi-Fi and stay chill with 99.99% network reliability. Get extreme internet, starting at $19.99 a month for 1 year. Dial 844-EXTREME2.
Are you over 50? Would you like to get up to 33% more income in retirement? Then call now for this free book, Annuity Do's and Don'ts for Baby Boomers, from a leading financial firm on maximizing your income in retirement. That's right, free. This free book reveals little-known secrets about annuity strategies in simple-to-understand terms that will help you make the right choices before buying an annuity. And it's free. Call right now for your free book. And as a bonus, we'll also throw in a free annuity rate report. We researched over 1,200 annuities and summarized the rates and benefits of annuities from financially strong insurers. Again, that's Annuity Do's and Don'ts for Baby Boomers and a free annuity rate report, both absolutely free for calling Annuity General today. Supplies are limited. Call now.
Call 800-816-8219. That's 800-816-8219.
Join us weeknights for Live at 5 as we go around the Northland, city by city.
RJ Sport, first annual in-house boat show, February 15th through the 20th.
Coming up tonight, what medical professionals want you to know ahead of spring break travel.
Boy, it was cold again this morning, and we'll have another cold one tomorrow morning, but then we should start to warm up. We'll talk about the process
tonight at 6 on CBS 3.
Local news and local weather here on CBS 3.
Now, the CBS 3 Duluth WeatherMax forecast with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
Well, big news for us Ely boys over the weekend. Snowbank Lake, 25 miles east of Ely and Winton there, up the Fernberg Road, got pretty cold. Set a record for that region at 50 below on Saturday. I remember going there once with my dad fishing in the 70s, and that was cold enough. Had to use those big, thick Air Force Arctic wear gloves. 50 below is even colder. It must have been 30 below then. Bottom line, though, hopefully things are going to start to warm up this week. A warming trend slightly began today. We'll kind of relapse tomorrow morning with more brisk temperatures towards 30 below. But after that, we could go towards warmer than normal by the weekend. So we'll talk about that progress after we take a look at other towns' low temps from this morning, because it hit 39 below in Hibbing and International Falls, and 38 below even in Hayward, 32 degrees below zero for our friends in Watersmeet. And it looks like Grand Marais right by the lake was the hot spot at 19 below. And again, we're doing that one more time tomorrow before we start to moderate our temperatures slowly and semi-surely, which will culminate perhaps in 30 above by next Monday. But no, not this Monday. Current conditions at Duluth International, one above. We'll call that partial success and a partial approach towards finally warming up. North-northwest winds going 6 miles per hour, could hit 15, so the entire region faces another night with a wind chill advisory. Air pressure's high at 30.45 inches of mercury, and taking a look at the situation, because the air pressure is high, there aren't too many clouds in the sky. They try to form up, and then they're pushed right back down again from the Arctic high pressure that's now taken over pretty much the eastern two-thirds of the nation, even down towards Texas, where they had temperatures cold enough to fuel a pretty big snowstorm. Well, that pool of cold air, like I mentioned, will start with us here on Tuesday morning, but by Tuesday afternoon, we may dare to go all the way towards 8 above, and that's just a step towards the stones of being tossed towards the temperatures that will take us up perhaps into the 20s by the weekend. But in between, there will be a flurry chance coming our way Wednesday as the Arctic high pressure retreats back to the north and moves towards the east. It's only a 20% chance for the flurries, but we've been so cold and so dry, except for a couple of flurries in the past 10 days or so, to hear that a slight 20% chance on Wednesday is pretty big news to talk about. And then there's another chance for snow coming on the weekend. We'll tell you which part. with our 7-day forecast. Then we begin tonight in Minnesota, where the actual air temps go 15 to 30 below again. Wind chill factors 30 to 40 below. Wisconsin and Michigan, oh, about 20 to 25 below there as well. And then for tomorrow, another sunny day comes our way, but high temps in Wisconsin and the UP are 10 to 13 above. Minnesota numbers 6 to 11 above. Yes, we'll turn the temperatures up to 11, and then we'll get even warmer after that. Here's our extended forecast. We will go towards 12. Then 15 for Thursday and Friday. Saturday should come up around 20. 25 on Sunday with a 40% chance for what looks like light snow right now. And then next Monday, 30 degrees above zero, Kristen. Get out the sunscreen. You know, all the old cliches about when it starts to go towards the freezing mark for us Minnesotans, Wisconsinites, and Michiganders. You know, we put on the shorts and put on the shades and go out and frolic.
My favorite thing to do is open my sunroof in my car.
Oh,
when
yeah.
it gets warm enough after brutally cold temperatures like we've been seeing, I love to open that up.
Mm-hmm.
Just pretend I'm in the summer.
Yeah, and then if it actually hit 50, we'd be turning on the
air conditioning. Oh, my goodness, we would. Yes. Thanks, Dave. Here's a live look from Giants Ridge in Biwabik, Minnesota. And while hitting the slopes is a popular thing to do around here, some people might be opting for a warmer adventure after those brutally cold temperatures we've been seeing. But with the ongoing pandemic, medical professionals want you to keep several things in mind if you do choose to travel, even with people getting vaccinated. CBS3's Emma Quinn explains more from the Duluth International Airport.
Many may be considering booking a trip to warmer weather this spring break, but medical professionals at the CDC and St. Luke's Hospital want you to think twice before packing your suitcase. If you do choose to travel, you will need to provide a negative test result for international travel. As every country and airline company has different requirements, St. Luke's nurse practitioner Sherry Johnson says it's best to get your test done 3 days before your trip. Johnson also recommends being diligent about masking, social distancing, and hand sanitizing.
All of our efforts, I think, are paying off, but we can't let up now. We don't want people to come back from spring break and bring that back to us as a souvenir.
When you return from vacation, Johnson says you still need to quarantine and get tested for COVID before resuming regular activities. Now, some people may be traveling for work, school, or work service in other countries. Johnson wants to remind those people that St. Luke's International Health Center is still open for pre-trip checkup appointments.
Thanks, Emma. And Johnson added the CDC is having conversations about whether you will need a proof of a COVID vaccine to travel in the future, but says right now you don't. Well, looking ahead, Thomas the Tank Engine will be chugging its way back to Duluth this summer. The North Shore Scenic Railroad will be hosting Day Out with Thomas in August. Families will have the opportunity to ride with Thomas and Percy the Tank Engines, photo opportunities with the characters, live music, and many other activities to do at the Railroad Museum. Tickets are on sale online and by phone. We have more information on our website. A local radio station is asking for your help to bring smiles to our seniors. Throughout this month, Life 97.3 is encouraging others to make notes or cards with fun stories, drawings, or motivating words. The Notes of Hope initiative expects these letters will bring a bit of joy and happiness to those at assisted living centers. The station will hand out the notes to residents in centers around the Northland. You can drop them off at the Life 97.3 Ministry Center in Duluth. Still to come, a new look at Mars from a country that hasn't been past Earth's orbit before now. We'll show you after the break.
Yes, it's a good day for singing a song, and it's a good day.
Get your new air and snow blower from Duluth Lawn and Sport, 4715 Grand Avenue, Duluth.
Last year, when people were going hungry, Subaru and our retailers donated 50 million meals to Feeding America. And yet, one in four children may still face hunger. So as part of our love promise, Subaru and our retailers are doing it again, donating an additional 100 million meals to help those in need. Love, it's never been needed more than right now. Subaru, more than a car company.
It is the question that matters the most.
¿Dónde está?
That takes you behind the story.
Robert.
It is the question. And without it, our purpose and our freedom fade. This is why.
I'm Clarice.
Are you famous?
Sort of.
You've got iron in your veins, darling.
I don't like this, Clarice.
I am trying to find out how deep this goes.
Buffalo Bill can't seem to let you go.
Just doing my job.
Our schools provide so much more than just learning support.
The school year didn't start out the way that we wanted it to, but who's to say it won't be better at the end?
We need to slow the spread so our economy has a chance to recover.
So our kids can be in school and be on the ice.
And we can keep our friends and families safe.
For our students and teachers.
For our essential workers.
For the people you love.
Thank you for doing your part. Go Hunters!
Okay, Dad. One, two, three.
Ah! You saved me.
Dad?
Are you okay?
I'm fine, dear.
Your hero needs you now, and AARP is here to help. Find the care guides you need at aarp.org/caregiving.
Everything that happens on a day-to-day basis in terms of news, no matter what happens in news, weather is always constant. Weather is always changing as well, so it's still an important role as the meteorologist to kind of still stay grounded and to kind of just know that role and what to take and kind of just make sure you're delivering what's the most important for your viewers. But then also, I like to touch base on the national things. All of those news stories also tie in with weather stories because they do go kind of hand in hand.
Watch Jenna and Caitlin in the morning at 5 and 6 a.m.
Local news and local weather here on CBS 3.
Welcome back. There are new images taken of Mars from a probe sent by the United Arab Emirates. The spacecraft named Hope is the first from an Arab nation to reach the orbit of the red planet. The main goal of the mission is to reveal secrets about Martian weather, but the UAE Space Agency also hopes this first ever flight will inspire young people. To mark the big milestone, visitors received a special stamp on their passport. After making the 300 million mile journey to Mars, Hope will now circle the planet for 2 years. Experts say it's getting crowded up there. China's probe reached the planet just a day after the UAE's. And on Thursday, NASA's Perseverance rover is scheduled to land.
Coming up on the CBS Evening News. The winter weather nightmare as Texas sees its coldest temperatures in decades and millions in the state lose power. What the rest of the country can expect for later this week. Plus, with more than 14 million Americans fully vaccinated against COVID-19, one expert's warning that the worst of the pandemic could still be yet to come. And how the residents of the Big Easy are keeping Mardi Gras alive in the age of social distancing. That's tonight on the CBS Evening News.
CBS 3 closed captioning is brought to you by Essentia Health, St. Mary's Heart and Vascular Center. Don't avoid care during COVID-19. Ask your doctor how to stay heart healthy.
Keeping yourself and your family safe from germs and bacteria is made easy with Cetus Ultraviolet technology for sterilization. Through time-tested ultraviolet irradiation, killing 99% of dangerous microbes is simple and effortless. UV light technology is faster and more reliable than water-based disinfectants. Now easier than ever to live germ-free. Visit www.cetusonline.com. That is CETUSonline.com.
Lake Superior College is nationally recognized for quality and affordability, offering over 90 programs, including career, technical, and general studies for transfer. At LSC, you can start here, save thousands. Apply for free at lsc.edu.
With locations throughout the Northland and Northern Wisconsin, Super One Liquor has you covered for all of your party and gathering needs. We have a commitment to deliver outstanding service, variety, and top quality wines and spirits. And don't forget the best variety of ice cold beer and beverages, all at the low prices you've come to expect. Super One Liquor. Come for the service, leave with the savings.
Join Black Bear Casino Resort as we give you a chance to multiply your moolah. Saturdays in February from 6 to 9 p.m., three players each hour will be selected and get a chance to multiply their moolah up to $7,500 in cash. 12 lucky winners every Saturday in February. Earn entries starting January 31st. For more information, visit blackbearcasinoresort.com. Multiply your moolah Saturdays in February and make the Bear your place.
Men's Wardrobe provided by Mainstream Fashions for Men. Celebrating 30 years in business in 2021 with 30% off store-wide. Downtown Duluth.
Welcome back to the CBS 3 News live at 5. Here's a live look from Canal Park on this Monday evening. Let's take a look back at today's top story and see what's coming up at 6. Tonight we learned more about former President Donald Trump's second impeachment trial over the weekend and how some lawmakers aren't satisfied with the decision. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi sent a letter to colleagues earlier this month supporting the idea of a 9/11 style commission to investigate the assault. And tonight at 6, hear even more about what experts are saying about traveling, vaccine or no vaccine, ahead of the spring break travel season. That's your news at 5. The CBS Evening News is next. We hope to see you right back here at 6.